How's it going? Sorry I'm a little late. I gotta plug this other microphone in. Had an issue with the multi-camera shoot software stuff, not talking to Facebook, so I couldn't stream multi-camera, which is challenging for what I wanted to demonstrate. Bear with me. There we go. Got okay, there, we're back. So, how's everybody doing? Dan Schinder here on Drum Talk TV, and have some fun planned. Yes, I do, but first off, more importantly, how are you doing? How's the audio? Let me know. We're going to play some fun stuff, and I want to address something really, really fun. So first, let me mute myself here. First, tell me where you're watching from. I'm in Globe, Arizona, which is 100 miles east of Phoenix, off the 60 up in the mountains. I want to turn this camera a little bit. Hopefully I won't knock it over. Is that a little better? We'll see. So, a funny thing happened on the way to the show. I can't say this with a straight face. So, we posted this meme earlier today. I'll look at comments in a moment. We posted a meme earlier today, Batman and Robin, and basically, well, actually, Steve, my son, is going to post a link to it in the comments. And all it said was, basically, if you're going to play Led Zeppelin, only play what Bonzo played, no double pedal. And it's like half our audience will... not really that many, but basically lost their shit. Oh my God. Excuse my language, but I can't believe how seriously people take stuff. It's a Batman and Robin cartoon. And so where it comes from is I made this meme a couple years ago because I grew up playing a lot of Led Zeppelin and only played what Bonzo played. The five piece plus the two timpanis, one pedal. Yes. John Bonham had a double bass in the very, 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 very beginning, and Jimmy Page took it away, basically. so I learned all this, but I just can't believe people freaking out. Oh, you shouldn't be a gatekeeper to how people play music and just all this stuff. Come on, really? Really? With all the stuff going on in the world? Really? I just can't believe it. So I thought I would break that down. Now I'm at a little bit of a... well, not disadvantaged, but I'm a little disappointed because I was going to do a multi-camera shoot and have the foot cam. So I'm going to play it here first. Then I'm going to come around, grab the camera, put it on. Where's the other little tripod thingy? Put it on the little tripod thingy I have over there so you could just see the foot. Because I want you to see how I do it, and I'll break it down. So that suggestion came from myself. But then I'm going to play something from Drum Talk TV fan Wendy Preischel. I hope I'm pronouncing your name right, Wendy. And let me know if you're watching, Wendy. Wendy suggested something by Michael Shreve from the Woodstock Santana era. So I'm going to play something from a year or two later. It's Santana at Tanglewood. Oh, 1970, actually. And I'll play that. I'll play Black Magic Woman live for four reasons. One, because Wendy suggested it. Two, because my wife is black. Three, she's magic. And four, she's a woman. Black, get it? There you go. And she was here, but now she's not. She was here because she works the switcher when we do the multi-camera shoot thing. And she said, so do you still need me? I said, no, but you're welcome to stay. She said, oh, I'm going to get some other work done. She went up to the offices. So let's see. Let me see what's going on here. Paul Unger says, cool kid, thank you very much. Brian Cahoon, thanks for joining in. Good so far. Norfolk, Virginia, cool Paul. Pat Sam says, I play drums at church and want to add another cymbal. How do you go about picking one? You know, it depends on the sound you want, the kind of music you play, and all of that. Yes, Brian, everyone's overly critical when it comes to that. I mean, give me a break. Lab coats, hang it up. Put your pocket protector in the drawer and hang up your lab coat. Mark Cole says, make the same meme for Iron Maiden. Yeah. Kit looks cool. Awesome. You guys will hear it in just a moment. I can play Wagon Wheel. Cool, cool. What's up from New Orleans? Ah, my wife and I were just talking about wanting to go there. Not during all this BS, though. So, I'm going to play. First, I'm going to do this. So, here's the beat. We're talking about good times, bad times, since John Bonham's single bass drum became such a topic today. So, I'm going to play it in slow motion. That's one pedal, okay? Here it is in real time. Now, I'll play to the song, then I'll have to come around, get the camera, and put it down on a little tripod thingy so you can see what I'm doing with my foot. And just so you know, I hope this isn't gross to anyone. Actually, I'll show you when the camera's down there so you can see. I was going to hold my leg up so you could see what I'm wearing on my feet. I played in socks for a long time. Used to play in athletic shoes and stuff. Then I switched to socks and loved it. Then once I played in pool shoes, and it was great because I could feel every little thing, had all this flexibility. So I'm playing in old ratty pool shoes. There's the meme. Steve's going to peem that. It's Cymbal Heaven. I play a lot of progressive stuff. Yes, Genesis, ELP, UK, Asia, hence the different textures and symbols and stuff. I actually have some that are put away. So let's go. And I'm playing to the official version, which you're not supposed to do. So I'm going to let it play, the beginning play out, and then come in after the drums start to reduce the chance of it getting muted. Fair enough? Okay, here we go. We'll start the song and I'll jump in a moment and do my best. I won't do my best, I'm sure. I haven't played in a while. Well, I haven't played this in a while. So I'll jump in right after they come in. I should have warmed up. Just do that much. I think I can't hear the vocals, so I think something came unplugged beyond the PA. Hold on. Yes, old school. I'm playing the PA. Playing through a PA. Whoa, speaker almost fell. Not sure what's going on. There's my Ahead Spinal Glide Throne. Love that thing. Everything looks plugged in. I'm not sure why I don't hear the vocals. But let me move the camera, okay? And then we'll play that again. So you could actually see what the foot's doing. If you're just joining us, read the description, and you'll kind of know what's going on. I wrote the description, and I hardly know what's going on. So there you go. Anyways, how's everyone's beginning of the year going? What was I going to do? Oh, yeah, move the camera. One sec. Give me a second. Tour of the kit as I do this. Let me grab the little tripod thing. One sec. Alright. Let me see if I can situate this so you can see the bass drum pedal. 1 second. There. Okay, so you could see I have a double pedal, which I rarely use. I almost never use it. Is that a good, can you see the plate? Yeah, you can. So you'll see how I play it now. 1 second. Let me go around and you'll see the pool shoes I was talking about. And you'll see how I play with just the ball of my foot, which is just this. Can you see that? So hold on. Here we go. So I'm just going to play it without the music for a moment. I'll slow it down. By the way, John Bonham uses the same sort of, I call it a flutter. He uses it towards the end of the live version of Black Dog from the Song Remains the Same movie, where it goes, I'll play it real soft first, so it goes, ba-da-ba-da, 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 ba-da-ba-da. Anyhow, does that make sense? I'm going to look at comments real quick. And then I'll play to the song again, hopefully a lot better than I did the first time. But I want to make sure so far it makes sense with the foot thing going on. So let's see. Raf Vivas asked what kind of kit it is. I'll give you a tour right after this. It's part Pearl, part Slingerland, part Tama, actually. And this isn't even the whole kit, believe it or not. But it's certainly enough for what I play. So, Earl, explain yourself. Bro, you're failing at this shit. How so? Let me know. Milt Surratt, how you doing, Dan? You're so real. I love you, man. Well, thank you. This is the only way I know how to be. I'm real good at being me. Rico Shepherd, thank you. Joseph McMillan, thank you very much. Brian Kuhn says, I'd still play both pedals, but that's just me. I don't even know how to play this with both pedals. The only thing I know how to do with both pedals is this. Watch, just these little, watch, like. I mean, I could do very little. I could do this, like. But I can't even play this song that I've been playing for 50 years, basically, which is weird. I think that's weird. I admit it's weird. thank you for the flutter comment. I first learned in the 90s on the double bass. Cool. I've never really been a double bass person. I've only had a double bass for a very short time. Nice bounce on the kick. Thank you. I love the access pedals, Raph. I really do. So cool. Here we go. I'm going to play to the song now. So watch the foot. Watch the foot. Take my glasses off. Steve Schinder, watch for the flag notice. You know what I mean. Here we go. Yeah. you, right? So again, I'll play it slow. Whoops. Let me try that again. I hope that makes sense. So bear with me. I'm going to move the camera back. Actually, I told you I'd give a quick tour of the kit. So let me put my glasses on and do that. Give me your feedback on that, please. And then I'm going to fill Wendy's request and play Black Magic Woman. So let's start from the front here. This kit's very old, like me. I'm probably a little older than a lot of you think. Maybe not. I mixed that color in 1983. I mixed it myself. A guy who painted show cars painted it. What happened was, you know, let me turn the music off one sec. Let me pause this. Okay, so quick story. The kit's made up of three different brands, and there were three different finishes. I wanted to get them all the same. My older cousin who was in the band knew some guy who painted show cars. So I mixed this color paint myself. He painted them, came back way too dark. But I had a recording session like 3 days later. So I told my tech, Mike, who was with me for 23 years, I said, Mike, let's just put the top heads on because we got to take all this stuff apart in a few days and send it back anyways. So we did that, and these already were concert toms. They're Slingerland concert toms from like 1976, I believe. And we left all the other bottom heads on, and there was more drums than this, actually, and they're just put away. And we left the front bass drum off and went to the recording session, and the drums sounded amazing. So came home, took them apart, sent them back. They came back painted the right color, and I loved the sound so much I never put the bottom heads back on or the front head except for a video we made. And this was back in 83, and I've just fallen in love with that. So the timpani drums were owned by Mel Zelnick, who played with Artie Shaw and people like that. He had a music store called The Music Stop not far from us. My dad took me to see Led Zeppelin in 1977, and I begged my parents, who even asks this? I want timpani drums. I played them in the school orchestra and band, and they found these. He was selling them for $700. Now, even though that was 1977 and a lot of money, still it was mind-blowing. They're fiberglass, so they're light, the basses are cast, and they're pedal-tuned, and I just love them. This is an auxiliary snare that I have kind of tuned sort of like a timbale, but not can't really get the sound I want out of it like a timbale with that head. I'll talk about the heads in a minute. And then the toms are a combination of a 1979 Imperial Star by Tama and a 1970 Pearl kit, my first Pearl kit, my first drum kit, and the bass drum's a 24-inch as part of the Tama kit. You see the badge. I still have the original badge that we put back on. And so there you go. The cymbals are a combination of Zildjian, Sabian, and Wuhan. So I got this little Wuhan china there, got the big one there, and got the gong, which I love. I love those. Oh, and an LP bell, which you could wear as an army helmet as well. And then I've got a combination of different Zildjians. This is from their cheapest line, and I love it. And so is this. So you just never know sometimes. And an ice bell, I don't remember who even makes that. Sabian splashes, Sabian ozone over there. And I've had this ride literally forever. It's half cleaned and half not. Long story. And the heads are Remo color tone. I got the jelly bean mix. I just picked out the colors by size. We got pink, yellow, green hiding under there, amber, and then red and purple, blue snare, blue bass drum, and the gray power stroke on that snare, and the blue power stroke on that snare. So the power stroke doesn't really give the timbale sound that I wanted. Yeah, I know, they're kind of scuffed up and scratched up. They're old, and they've been around the world a couple times. ran out of Brasso. No, it's actually a dumber story than that. But anyhow, so I'm going to take this off and put it up on the big tripod, and then I'm going to play Black Magic Woman and maybe even fool around a little bit more. Feel free to talk about anything related to music or drumming. Just give me a second to hang this back up on the big tripod. 1 second. I just got to unscrew this thing. That thing is by Creative Percussion. It's called a hat stack. It's really cool. Where is it? There it is. All right. Let me put this here. Sorry for the dizzy ride. Okay, thanks for being patient. I'm sorry that we couldn't do the multi-camera shoot like I had planned. It would have been so much easier for my wife to switch to that camera. You know what? That camera looks like it's going to fall. Hold on 1 sec. Guess it's okay. Oops. I guess that's okay. All right. So, how about some Michael Shrieve with Santana, 1979? But first, let's peek at the comments, see what's happening, what's going on. Hope everybody's well. Ooh, the gong. Yeah, we'll just turn it slightly. There we go. Ooh, 16 new comments. Okay, let me catch up to you folks. Give me a sec. Oh, did I see Kelly Ray Tubbs? Oh, Joseph McMillan say my favorite drummer is Tubbs. Got to train the cat. She's smart enough, that's for sure. Really digging this. I am learning all new. That's really cool. Thank you. I'm so glad you're finding this of value. I got the Mongrel Surratt who played with Zappa in the early 60s. Very nice. Sir Langland's my first drum set. Sorry, I'm reading backwards. Hey, John Kensting, what's happening? I need to make some adjustments to the pedal. So the foot cam was temporary, John. We couldn't do the multi-camera shoot. Yeah, more toe, zero heel. I can't play with my heel down. I can't even play the hi-hat with the heel down. Oh, I pronounced your name right. Nice, Raf. Nice, nice. Okay, so I don't know if Wendy's on board. Wendy suggested something by Michael Shrieve from the Woodstock era of Santana. This is from a couple years later, 1970, Black Magic Woman. I'm dedicating this to Wendy for suggesting it and to my wife, Angie, who's a black magic woman. I mean, she's black, she's magic, and she's a woman. There you go. All right, here we go. See if I remember this. With Greg Raleigh. I'm not good at Latin beats, so this is a real challenge for me. Can't hear it. Hold on a sec. Oh, that's a horrible recording. Let me find a different version of that. 1 second. I'm sorry. I got to be able to hear this stuff. My hearing's challenging enough as it is. So give me 1 sec. Boop, boop, boo-doo. Let's see if this is better. Huh. What's going on here? I got it. All right. There's, you know what? I got to tell you something funny. So I started playing that, and I just happened to remember that this Wednesday, on the, what would that be, 13th, lucky 13, Cindy Blackman Santana is my guest at noon Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern U.S. times. And I thought, I really hope she's not watching right now. So join me for that. I'm very excited to have Cindy on for her first long-form interview with me. Let me go back to you folks, the most important part of the show. And thank you, everybody, for putting up with me, by the way. Let me scroll up and get caught up. And by the way, I'm open to, I'll do one more song. I'll look at some suggestions by either ELP, Yes, or Genesis. Yeah. Let me see here. Scrolling down. From Fishman. Ah, nice, Joseph McMillan. Let's see, I play cosmic percussion only. Now all I can afford, that's okay. Hey, brands don't matter to me. I mean, what I mean is, what you play isn't what comes out of you. The gear you play, I'm not saying gear doesn't matter. It's not, it wouldn't be nice to have great gear, but I'm saying what comes out of you doesn't matter. My nephew probably wouldn't let me use the heel. I think you mean Sheila E., yeah. Let's see. Milt says, I've always said there are two types of drummers. Creative can play to anything by making up riffs to fill the song, and perfectionist plays the song exactly like it was played. You are creative. Thank you very much. There are some songs I do like to play as close as I can to exact, but I like to spread my wings a little bit and get creative. Thank you very much. That compliment means a lot to me. I'm going to grab a water. Oh, Bruford stuff. Okay. But I don't have any. I'll explain in a second. One second here. Stay right there. Please don't go anywhere. Give me more suggestions. Yes, ELP, Genesis, but I'll consider Bruford. Getting a water. My water's right down here. What a ding dong. Okay. So the thing about Bruford is I'm not familiar with a lot of the old Yes live stuff, because there's very little live stuff with Bill. My son Steve will hit me over the head for even saying that. So I'll learn some of that and work on it. I got to move the fridge closer, yeah, but there's no room with all these drums. Yeah, he was awesome. Great with King Crimson. Absolutely. Loved him with that. Ooh, Genesis, Dodo the Lurker. Who said that? Milt, you got it. A live version. How's that? Genesis, Dodo the Lurker. Let's do it. Let me find the right version. Thank you for the suggestion. Since now we're shifting to the Genesis topic, did you ever see Genesis live? Genesis, did I play it? Dodo live. I'm going to find a good version of this. One sec. That's from Three Sides Live. Soundboard. Let me put soundboard. We're almost there. We're almost there. Honk your horn if you saw Genesis live and when. I did see them a few times in the early 80s and their We Can't Dance tour at Dodger Stadium. I could have not have sat farther. I was all the way in the middle, all the way at the very top, and it was still amazing. Okay, so let's go with bear with me. I'm looking for the best version of this. I don't want to play to the official one. You know what? I will. Screw it. Let's play to the official one just because it'll be clearer, okay? Here we go. Ah, I love this. Chester Thompson on drums most of the time in this. But it's Phil's part, so it's, you know what I mean, right? Is that cool? Is that all right? Let me drag this back to the beginning. Here we go.
Thank you.
there's going to be a commercial? We'll go into the next one. Pretend they're still clapping. There we go. Oh, it didn't do it. It goes into Abacab. That was kind of lame. That was anticlimactic. Well, hopefully it was okay for you. Let's see. Let me scroll up. That was fun. I love that. Oops, I accidentally hid the comments. Okay, I'm back. See all. There we go. Okay, I'm back. All right. Thanks. Let me get caught up. Let me scroll to the right place. George Clinton's drummer played here once. He was awesome. Okay, cool. Thanks for all your feedback here. Phil is an amazing drummer. His stuff with Brand X was incredible. Ah, Carrie, you saw them in 80 and 83. Cool. I think I saw them in 80, if I have the tour years right, like 82, 83, 85, another year, and then the We Can't Dance tour or something like that. Thanks so much, Milt. Thanks for the suggestion. That was really cool. Okay, I'll do one more. Oh, but I got to keep it under an hour, so Steve, keep me on pace. Where are we? Let me know here, Steve. It is on. Oh, but I got to... You should be good. Okay, so ELP, yes, more Genesis. I'm just kind of in a progressive mood now. If you missed the beginning of this, I broke down the bass drum beat and the beat for Good Times, Bad Times by Led Zeppelin. I moved the camera down here so you could see my foot. So after this, if you missed that, rewind it. And there's a funny story that goes with it as to why I did that. Hey, all right. If there's no suggestions, maybe I'll just get back to work. Any suggestions I can play, that is. I still crack up every time I see Brian's message, move the fridge closer. I should have it back here. I didn't think of that, but then I'll be in it all the time, which isn't a big deal because all I do is drink water, which reminds me I should probably have some water. Let me know what's up. I'll take one more quick look. Thanks again for joining me. Thanks for following us on Drum Talk TV. I interviewed Gavin Harrison yesterday. Cindy Blackman is, I'm sorry, Gavin was Friday. Cindy Blackman is Wednesday the 13th. And then we've got Pick Withers from Dire Straits Friday. Guy Gelso from Zebra on Saturday. We're already getting the year started with some new interviews too, new guests. Cindy was on for a short interview at the NAMM show once. This will be totally different. Maybe she can bring that guitar player guy on. Oh, what's his name? All right. Yeah, gotta have the water. Roundabout. Maybe I'll play live Roundabout with Alan. Is that okay? Let me see if I get one or two more suggestions, then I'll pick, if that's all right. Sign up for the newsletter so you can get replays of the stuff you might have missed and get notices of stuff that's coming before anybody else. We will be doing some contests and giveaways, and I'll be advertising stuff with our buddies at Hudson Music competitions. We just had a Tommy Igo competition. We're announcing that on the 30th of this month, Rob Wallace and I, and we've got a play-along contest going. Steve says 45. Okay, so I got time for another good one. So sign up for the newsletter. The link is in the post. Can you play When We All Get to Heaven by Alan Jackson? Connor, I'm embarrassed to say I don't know that song. I'm not familiar with it. I've got kind of here's what's weird. I have sort of a narrow library, but it's a very difficult one, if that makes any sense. I'll look that up, though. Thanks. If it's worth requesting, it's probably worth playing. All right, so one more sip of water, then I'll figure this out real quickly. Heavy on the water. I don't really drink anything else anymore. Okay. Clock is ticking. What am I gonna do? Okay, let me look real quick. Keys. Okay, I can't let the beginning play or the middle because it'll get muted, but we'll take a chance on this one. Stephen's going to be busy dealing with the flagged notices. So I'll tell you a yes story while we're getting to the part that I can play to. I've known Alan since 1989, and I knew him long before I thought of Trump Talk TV, and he's been on a lot of times, which has been fun. And I've seen Yes probably 20 times, maybe. The first time was in the round 1978, the Toronto tour. Huge Yes fan. I probably could play almost their whole catalog, especially everything from, well, here we go. Ready? Sing it if you know it. Thank you. That up. Okay, so we'll come back as soon as the band comes back in, because if I let it broadcast through the tacit without the drums, the Facebook algorithm will recognize it and it'll mute it. So we're going to wait till after they say in and around the lake, so you can sing that with me. And then it's one of my favorite Rick Wakeman organ solos. I love it. So everyone good? Yeah? After this, we'll wrap it up. Here we go. Lake, mountains come out of the sky. I don't think you folks are still there. It looks like the signal dropped. That sucks. Let me intercom over to Steve and ask him. Hey, Steve, did the signal drop? It says to me, sorry, we're having trouble playing this video. And is there a flag, perhaps? And is there a copyright flag, perhaps? Maybe that's why it stopped. Hey, if you're still watching, folks, thanks for joining me. Dan Schinder here on Drum Talk TV in Globe, Arizona, 100 miles east of Phoenix, up in the mountains. And I appreciate you following us so much. I will look at comments over the next couple days. If you're watching it on the archive and you made it this far, thank you very much. Unless you started at the end, well, then that's just cheating. So thank you very much. Okay, so I'm done, and we'll see you later. Oh, I gotta go over here and turn it off real quick. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Bye bye. The signal disappeared on my end. Hopefully not on yours. Over now. Talk to you soon.